you're in Maui during the height of humpback whale season and you just go for a swim in the ocean, typically you will hear the chorusing in the background of humpback whale song. Humpback whale males are the ones who sing.
The humpback whale song is kind of otherworldly because it combines these elements of low frequency sounds together with these really high notes and all kinds of things sort of in between. And that's part of the reason what makes the song so interesting and unique, because you really get the sense that the whales are trying to kind of show off their range.
It's quite beautiful and melodic, and other than human language, it's been touted as one of the most complex vocalizations in the animal kingdom.
Surfacing.
Each year, approximately half of the North Pacific humpback whale population migrates roughly 3,000 miles from its feeding grounds in southeastern Alaska to its breeding grounds in Hawaii.
The majority of the whales will be here between January and March.
When they're in the breeding grounds, other than newborn calves that are feeding on their mother's milk, the whales are largely fasting.
So the amount of time that they can spend here is going to be dictated by the energy stores that they've built up over the summer.
While in the breeding grounds, the male whales perform their haunting song.
All the whales in Hawaii sing approximately the same song.
Based on genetics, now there is believed to be 14 distinct population segments of humpback whales around the world.
There are very large differences between the song that is produced, let's say, here in the North Pacific and what we have in the South Pacific, because those are entirely different populations. And those whales do not interact with each other.
There's three or four other whales singing.
When the breeding season starts, the whales are singing the same song that they ended with at the previous season. The song evolves in certain ways over the course of a breeding season. There may be innovators in the singing community in Hawaii. It may be that there are whales from other breeding areas that go up to similar feeding grounds and they've come down to the Hawaii breeding grounds and are bringing some changes in the song that the other males are adopting. And that combination leads to the song kind of evolving over the course of a season. So at the end of the season, when you record song, there are some slight differences that are very noticeable from the beginning of the season. If you record song over several years, you may hear that those small changes lead to large scale changes.
There's still so much we don't understand, even just some very basic questions as to what the function of their song is, and there's just been a lot of debate about that.
How do scientists study humpback whale song? And what might it tell them about the fitness of an individual whale?